वेरी गुड वेरी गुड वेरी गुड। सो लेट्स स्टार्ट विद द सेशन गाइस। इन दिस चैप्टर यू विल अंडरस्टैंड अबाउट टाइम एंड वर्क। सो लेट्स स्टार्ट विद द फर्स्ट क्वेश्चन एंड इन दिस थ्रू दिस क्वेश्चन यू विल अंडरस्टैंड ऑल द बेसिक कंसेप्ट। गाइस दिस इज द क्वेश्चन फॉर योर बेसिक कंसेप्ट। बेसिक क्वेश्चन गाइस दिस इज वन क्वेश्चन। यस साई कृष्णा आई विल। साई कृष्णा इज कमेंटिंग सर वी एक्सपेक्ट ए मैथमेटिक्स बुक फ्रॉम यू। ओके आई विल। यस यू कैन गिव द आंसर्स। आई नो गाइस यू ऑल नो हाउ टू सॉल्व दिस क्वेश्चन बट एज आई एम स्टार्टिंग दिस चैप्टर। यस नेश राइट। एज आई एम स्टार्टिंग दिस चैप्टर सो आई हैव टू स्टार्ट दिस चैप्टर फ्रॉम द वेरी 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 बेसिक बिकॉज आई हैव टू टेक केयर टू ऑल द स्टूडेंट्स वीक स्टूडेंट्स एज वेल एज द स्ट्रॉन्गेस्ट स्टूडेंट्स। ऑलराइट। सो इन दिस क्वेश्चन इज वेरी 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 गुड टू अंडरस्टैंड द बेसिक कंसेप्ट ऑफ द टाइम एंड वर्क। इन दिस क्वेश्चन गाइज इन दिस क्वेश्चन प्लीज लिसन। इन दिस क्वेश्चन वी हैव बीन गिवन दैट ए कैन डू ए पीस ऑफ वर्क इन 10 डेज, बी कैन डू द सेम वर्क इन 15 डेज, देन इन हाउ मेनी डेज बोथ कैन कंप्लीट द वर्क टूगेदर। जस्ट लिसन केयरफुली आई विल टेल यू द रीजन वाई वी आर टेकिंग एलसीएम्स ऑल्सो एंड आई विल टेल यू द मिस्ट्री बिहाइंड दिस टाइम एंड वर्क and you will enjoy after knowing that mystery behind this time and work concept. Okay, so just listen. I know you all know about this question. This is very 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 easy question but I'm starting from the very basic. Okay, so guys here I am having A can do a piece of work in 10 days, B can do the piece of work in 15 days. All right, so I'm taking LCM of these two, that is 15 and the short. Now, the traditional method of taking LCM is this, as you all know, 2, 5, 15, 5, 1, 3, 3, 1, 2, 5, LCM is what? 2 into 5 into 3, that is 30. So this is traditional method. Please don't do like this. Now, you are going to appear in a competition, so don't do like this. First, understand the meaning of the LCM. LCM is what? Least common multiple. That means we have to find a least number which is completely divisible by 10. And 15, 10 and 15. All right. So what you need to do is you have to take 15 and read the table of 15 till 10 divides that number. That is 15 into 15. 15 does not divide it by 10. So go further. 15 to the 30. 30 is divided by 10 and divided by 15 also. So 30 is the LCM. This is the shortest way to find the LCM. So this is total work. Let's say this is 30 unit. Now, 30 divided by 10. This is 3 unit per day. 30 divided by 15, this is 2 unit per day and this is 3 to 5 units per day. This is nothing but 1 day work. 1 day work. All right guys, so please try to understand the concept. Let the total work be 30 unit. If someone is doing 30 unit work in 10 days, then 1 day work is 3 unit per day. Or you can say if someone is doing 3 unit per day, then he will complete 30 units in 10 days. Now, in order to find in how many days A and B together can do the work, what we have to do? Always remember, if you have to find the number of days, then this will be equal to total work upon 1 day work. You need not to remember this formula. There is, I will not use any single formula throughout the chapter. Okay? I will not use any single formula throughout the chapter. Don't worry. Guys, 1 day work of A is 3, 1 day work of B is 2, the 1 day work of both of them is 5. As we have 30 units to complete the total work, and A and B together completes 5 units per day, then they will complete the whole work in 6 days. This will be your answer. Okay, so this is a kind of method that is called LCM method. You all are well aware of this method. But question arises in my mind, why I am taking LCM? Why I am always taking this LCM? Okay, no problem. Take any other number. Let's check it out. What will happen? Take multiplication of these two. That is 150. I'm not writing these things again. This is total work. So this divided by this, 15, 1 day work. This divided by this, 10, 1 day work. This is 1 day work. And 1 day work is also called efficiency. Is also called efficiency. Now, total 1 day work is 25 as you can see, total work is what, 150. When we divide by the one day work of both, we will get the same answer. That means it is not necessary, it is not always necessary to take the LCM always. You can take any other number, you can take the multiplication of these two. Okay, now let's try to, guys, always do experiments in mathematics to better understand the mathematics. Always do experiments. So I am going to do some experiment with this question. Okay, if I want to, if I want that the question solution, I want to do the question solution wrong. Okay, I want that the question solution will be wrong. So I am, yes, you guys, you tell. Just see the magic now. You can take any number here. Okay, now tell me in the comment box what number I will take here. Take any number. Yes, guys, please tell me. Nikhil Agrawal is commenting 500. 500 is a very easy question number, yaar. Okay, Vivek Kumar is saying take 121. Okay, I'm taking 121. All right. Vivek Kumar is saying 121. Okay, that's okay. No problem. So this is total work. Just see the magic. Okay. Okay, no problem. So one day work is what? 121 divided by 10. This is what? 121 divided by 15. All right. Now, this is what? After adding this, you will have 121 divided by 10, 121 divided by 15. I am experimenting something. Okay. Please listen carefully. Now, if you have to find the number of days, total work is what? 121. And here we have 121 by 10 plus 121 by 15. Now, 121, take 121 common from here. We have 1 by 10, 1 by 15. This will cancel out with this. Now, we have 1 by 30, that is 2 plus 3. All right, that is 3 plus 2. And you will have 30 by 5. You will definitely have 6 days as your answer. Oh, now, what you understand about by this? What do you understand by this? This means in time and work, you can take any number in place of total work. Yes, guys, we can take any number. Yes, Naresh, I will explain, don't worry. We can take any number in place of total work. But why we are always taking this LCM? As you already checked that in this question, there is huge difference in method number one, method number second, and there is huge difference in first method and the third method in timing also. So LCM is better. Guys, LCM provides you the simple numbers to solve the question. So we are always taking LCM. So we will don't do like this. We always do like this. And LCM is the only tool which provides us the smallest numbers. LCM is the only tool which provides us the easiest number to solve a time and work question. Yes, Vivek Kumar, I'm explaining. That's why we are taking LCM to minimize the solution of the question. I hope you got the point. That's why we are taking the LCM. But if you are taking any number in place of total work, this will not affect your answer. I hope this point is clear to all of you. This is the basic idea of time and work. But we will do like this only. We will do like this only. Okay. This explanation is just for your better understanding the concept of time and work. I hope this point is clear to all of you. If yes, write in the comment box, yes, sir. Then we will move further. Yes, thank you, Vivek Kumar. Thank you so much. Yes, guys. Okay. So LCM method is best. Thank you, Vishwa, Vishwas. Thank you, dear. Thank you, Avinash. Avinash. Yes, Avinash is commenting. Avinash is commenting. No teacher have ever told this. Thank you so much for the great comment. All right. I have never known this concept if you are not told me. Thank you very much, Vishwa, Vishwas. Oh, thank you so much, yaar. Thank you so much. All right. Okay. Now let's move to the next concept. Next question. Okay. Yes, thank you, Vivek. Thank you. Guys, always remember one thing. Guys, always remember one thing. Always try to find the mystery of that behind that concept. Okay. Always try to find the mystery behind that, behind the every concept. And if you want to be good in mathematics, good at mathematics, so guys, always try to do some experiments. Okay. If you are thinking something that this is possible or not in mathematics, just do. Just do on paper and pen. You will go, maybe you will go two way. Either you will go for that solution, either you will understand something for that. Yes. Okay. Now, the next question is this. Now, please try to solve this question fast. Yes, guys, please try to solve this question. Thank you, Shantini. Thank you. Thank you so much. Okay. Please try to solve this question and give the answer in the comment box. I'm waiting for your great responses. Okay, yes, Vivek, 5 days is the correct answer. 5 days is the correct answer. Okay, so I will tell you this question. Guys, here we have A, B, C. A can do in 10 days, B can do in 15 days, this can do in 30 days. First take the LCM of these. Okay, first take the LCM of this. LCM of this is what? 30 degree, 30, sorry. This is total work. 10 threes are, 15 twos are, 30 ones are 30. You will get 6 as total work. So we have to find the total number of days if they work together. Total work is this, and total work done by all of them in one day is 6, 6, 5 is 30. That is 5 days will be the answer. I hope you get the point. So 5 is your answer. Guys, some peoples are doing this question in this way also. This does not make any difference. This is all about the layout. As I am from the forces, I am from BSF. I was inspector in BSF. And I was from defense, so I like the straight lines always. Okay, I like the straight lines always in place of these lines. Okay, so and always, guys, just see the layout of this question and just see the layout of this question. There is a huge difference. Okay, so always try to, yes, BSF has military force also. Yes, bilkul bilkul. All right, so let's move to the next question. I have served for plus years in border security force and as inspector, and I was posted in Bengal Siliguri area and I was best sub inspector, best inspector of my battalion. Now let's move to the next question. But I have a teaching passion, that's why I left that job, and I'm teaching right now, and I'm making more inspectors right now. Be an inspector, by an inspector, be an officer, by an officer. Oh, thank you. Very good, Naresh. Now let's move to the next question. Next question is this. Please try to solve this question. Now, the question is, A can complete a work in 15 days. Okay, A can complete a work in 15 days. A and B together can complete the same work in 10 days. Okay, A plus B can complete the same work in 10 days. Okay. In how many days B alone can complete that work? Guys, we are having A can complete the work in 15 days, A plus B can complete the work in 10 days. Now take the LCM of these two, we have 30. All right. Now this is 2, this is 3. In order to find the number of days of B, we have to find the one day work done by B alone. So here we have the total work. Here we have the one day work of A is 2 and one day work of A plus B is 3. Since one day work of A is 2 and one day work of A plus B is 3, then one day work of B is what? 1, obviously. So 30 days will be your answer. I hope you got the point. Is it clear to all of you? If yes, write in the comment box, yes sir. Okay, now let's move to the next question. Guys, level of the questions will increase question by question. Level of the question will increase question by question. Now please give the answer of this question. Yes, guys. Okay, now please try to understand this question. In this question, we have been given that A and B can do a piece of work in 20 days and 30 days. Okay, A can do in 20 days, B can do in 30 days, all right, respectively. While A, B, C together can complete the same work in 8 days, all right, A, B, C together can complete the work in 8 days, all right. We have to find in how many days C alone can complete that work. We have to find in how many days C alone can complete that work. Now, first of all, take the LCM. And LCM of these three numbers is, I told you the shortest method to find the LCM. What you need to do is, you have to take the bigger number and read the table of that number. Read the table of that number, all right? Take the bigger number and try to read the table of this number. 31 to 30, 30 is not divided by 20 and 8. 30 is cannot be LCM. 32 to 60, 60 divided by this but not by this. 33 to 90, 90 is not divided by this and this. 34 to 120, 120 is divided by this, this and this. So 120 will be the LCM. All right, guys. So this is total work. Okay. Now we have 6, 4, 50. So A completes. A can do 6 unit work in a day, B can do 4 unit work in a day, A, B, C all can do 15 units work in a day. In order to find the number of days taken by C, what we need to do is take total work here. All right. Now we are required to find the one day work of C. So here we have the total work, one day work of A and B is 10 and total work of A, B, C is 15. Then the one day work of, as we have the one day work of A and B is 10. One day work of ABC is 15, then one day work of C is 5. That is 24 days. I hope you got the point. Guys, these questions are very basic questions and it will help you to understand the concept of the timed work topic. All right. Now let's move to the next question. It is clear to all of you. If not, write in the comment box your query. If yes, write yes, sir, yes, sir, yes, sir. Then we'll move to the next question. Okay, so next question here we have this. Please try to solve this question, guys. Yes. Okay, so please try to solve this question, guys. In this question, A, given that A and B can do a work in 12 days, B and C can do the same work in 15 days, C and A can do the same work in 20 days. In this question, in how many days all working together can complete the whole work? Now, in this question, we have been given that A plus B can take 12 days, B plus C can take 15 days, C plus A can take 20 days. Alright guys, now take the LCM of these. LCM is 60, then the total work is 60. 5, 4, 3. We have to find the time taken by A, B, C together. Alright guys, so in order to find the time taken by A, B, C together, we have to find one day work, as we have the total work, so we have to find the one day work done by all together. So after adding this, we will get 5, 4, 9, 3, 12. 12. 12 is the one day work of 2A, 2B, and 2C. As you are having A, A, B, B, C, C. But we have to find the one day work of A, B, C. This is what? 6. If 2A, 2B, 2C are doing 12 work, then A, B, C will do 6 work, definitely. So, our answer will be 10 days. I hope this point is clear to all of you. If yes, write in the comment box. Yes, sir. Now, you tell, please, in how many days A alone can complete the work? In how many days B alone can complete the work? In how many days C alone can complete the work? Yes, guys, please try to give the answer of this question. In this question, if you are asked to find number of days taken by A alone, number of days by B alone, number of days by C alone, then what will be your answer? Please comment in the comment box. I am waiting. Yes. Yes, guys, please try to give the answer. Okay, Vivek Kumar, you're right. Okay, now I will solve this question, don't worry. Guys, as you already know, if you have to find the number of days taken by A alone, then you have to divide total work by one day work of A. So you are required to find the one day work of A. Okay, as you know that one day work of ABC is 6 and one day work of AB is 5, then one day work of C is 1. So the one day work of C is 1. If the one day work of C is 1 and B plus C is 4, then B will be 3. If B will be 3, then A will be 2. All right. Now, 60 by 2, that is 30 days. 60 by 3, that is 20 days. 60 by 1, that is 60 days. This is your answer. I hope you got the point. Is it clear to all of you? Yes or no? Is it clear to all of you? Write in the comment box, yes or no. All right, Budhim, don't worry. I'll repeat again. If you are having the total one day work of ABC, that is 6, and one day work of AB is what? 5. Then one day work of C is what? 1. All right, since the one day work of ABC is 6, one day work of AB is 5, then one day work of C is 1. If this is 1, this will be 3. If this is 3, this will be 2. All right, Sai Krishna. Now let's move to the next question. Now please try to solve this question, guys. So guys, from here, this question and this question. All right, these four or five questions are of basic type. In these questions you are now able to understand the basic concept of time and work. Now I am going to explain a new type of leaving the work, joining the work and all. So here we have this question. Okay, so please first try to solve this question, then I will explain how it is. Yes guys, please give the answer of this question. No Sai Kumar, you are wrong. No Sai Kumar Patnaik, you are wrong. Rahul Balihara, right. Vivek, you are right. Yes, very good Vivek and Rahul Balihara. Budhim, you are right. Yes Vivek, is it? Yes, it is 18. All right. Now in this question, Lakshmi Durga, you are wrong dear. In this question you have been given that A and B can do a piece of work in 20 and 30 days respectively. They both start the work together, but after 8 days A left the work. Rest of the work is completed by B. Then in how many days total work? I am saying total work here guys, please try to understand. Sai Kumar and Lakshmi Durga, I am saying total work here. Okay, now I will explain this question in detail, no problem. As in this question, we have been given that A can complete a work in 20 days, all right. B can complete that work in 30 days, all right. Take the LCM, 60. This is total work, okay. This is 3, this is 2, this is now, in this question, we have been given that they both start the work together, but after 8 days, A left the work. Guys, they start the work together, all right. They start the work together, okay. But after 8 days, A left the work. That means they work together for 8 days, isn't it? In this question, you have been given that they both start the work together, but after 8 days, A left the work. That means they work together for 8 days. Now A left only, B remains in the work. And we don't know how many days, for how many days B continues to the work. We have to find the total work. Okay? Sai Krishna and all, please understand, we have to find the total work. Total number of days of the total work. Okay, so first thing, you have been given that A plus B together work for 8 days. And A plus B can do 5 units work in a day. So in 8 days, they completed 40 units. Now you are left with 20. This 20 units is only for, this 20 units is remaining and this is expected to be done by B only. And B can do 2 units in 1 day. So he or she can do 20 units as per 2 units per day in 10 days. Then total number of days will be 8 days. And 10 days, then total number of days will be 18 days. I hope you got the point. I think this is clear to all of you. Just wait, Vivek. I will tell you all the things. It is just starting of the chapter. So I have to maintain the speed and the level as well. Okay, Vivek? So please, you have to wait. I think this is clear to all of you. Why we divide 2 by 2? Naresh, please understand that this 20 work is expected to be done by B and B can do 1 unit in a day, and what B have to do 20 units, and he is doing 2 units per day. So according, if he is doing 2 units per day and he has to do 20 units, then he will take 10 days. Okay, Naresh, so 10 days and 8 days, 18 days. But I will tell you the another method of this question. Okay, I will tell you the another method of this question. So this is a very basic method, and all the teachers and the students are doing with this method. But always remember, you are the students of Sandeep Sharma, Inspector Sandeep Sharma. So you need not to do like this in your exam. Okay, so I'm going to tell you a advanced method, that is another method. A is taking 20 days, B is taking 30 days. LCM is 60, 3, 2, total 5. Alright guys, now in this question we have been given that A plus B work for 8 days. Now A left, B remains at the work. Now guys, please understand, please try to understand one thing. Guys, always try to think without ink. Always try to think without ink. Okay, now just start thinking. Just start thinking. We have to find the number of days. Okay, so who left the work? Obviously A. B is working the work from the very start to the very end. B is working here from the start to end. From the start to end. That means the total number of days to be completed, to complete the total work, is equal to the total number of days taken by B on that work. I explain again. We have to find the total number of days. Okay. Now the total number of days will definitely be equal to the number of days worked by B here. So if I am able to find, the number of days taken by B, then we will get the answer. And you always remember, this 60 work is of A and B together. And what is the contribution of A here? Is of 8 days. I cancel out A from here. That is for 8 days. So 8 days contribution of A is 24. So after subtracting this, we will get 36 unit work. And this 36 unit work is only of B alone. And B can do 2 units in a single day, then B can do 36 unit in 18 days. So this will be your answer. Guys, always think without ink. Just take your time, don't worry. Just take your time and try to understand the thing. Please. Yes, Sai Krishna. Okay, I will tell you, don't worry. Yes, can I have the responses, please? Guys, this second method will save your time in your examination. Okay, Sai Krishna, you can do. Both methods are okay. Both methods are good, no problem. But I am telling you some more concepts. Okay? Guys, here we have to find the total number of days. And total number of days will be equal to... Okay, Lakshmi, I will tell you in the coming questions, don't worry. And total number of days will be equal to the number of work days work done by B. Okay, I will take, don't worry. So, okay, I will explain this again from the next question. Okay, please try to solve this question from the basic method as well as by the advanced method. Yes, Naresh is saying, sir, we are doing calculations by mental calculation. Very good. Very good, very good. Second method is best. Okay, guys, please listen. In this question, we have been given that A complete a work in 15 days, B complete the work in 20 days, C complete the work in 30 days. Okay, they all together start the work, but after 4 days, A left the work. Okay, Now I am writing here A, B, C. 15, 20, 30. LCM is what? 60. 4, 3, 2. That is 9. In this question, we have been given that all together start the work. That is A, B, C. After 4 days, A left the work. That means they work together for 4 days. Okay. Now we are left with only B and C. Okay. Now, in this question, we have been given that after next 4 days, B also left the work. After next 4 days, that means after leaving of A. Next 4 days, B also left the work. Now we are left with C only. And rest of the work completed by C. We don't know in how many days C completed the rest of the work. Then in how many days total work be completed? In how many days total work be completed? So, first we go by the basic method. So, here we are having ABC work together for 4 days. ABC can do 9 unit work in a day. That is 36 completed. B plus C can do 5 unit work in a day. So, in 4 days, 20 work completed. Their total work is 56. Total work is 56. So, the remaining work is 4 and this is for C. And as you can clearly see that C can do 2 unit work in a day. So, C has to do 4 unit. Then, to complete this 4 unit, he will take 2 days. So, here we have total days 4 days, 2 days. Then, the total work is in 10 days. So, 10 days will be the correct answer. This is by basic method. Alright guys, this is by basic method. And guys, if you do this question by that second method, you will know, you will better understand the importance of time. And by second method, you can do this question very fast. How many of you have done this question by the second option? How many of you have done this question by the second method? Please tell me. Write I in the comment box. Very good. Okay. Now I will also do it by second method. All right. Please try to understand this. If you are having A, B, C, 15, 20, 30. Okay. So LCM is 60, 4, 3, 2, 9. Okay. So guys, please listen. 4 days. B plus C, 4 days, C. Guys, we have to find the total number of days here, and total number of days will be equal to the number of days worked by C here, because C is from starting to end. So we are focused on C. Now try to find the number of days taken by C here. All right. So the contribution A is in this is of 4 day. Okay. I will remove it minus, and contribution B is what of 8 days. Okay, I will remove this also from here. Now we are left with 20. And 20 unit is the work especially for C only. Okay, and C is doing 2 unit work in a day. So 2 divided by 10, 2 divided by 2, 20 divided by 2 will have 10 days. So 10 days will be your answer. I hope you got the point. So guys, please tell me which one is best for you. Which one is best? First, either second. Either first method or second method. Please, can I have the responses, please? Everyone is saying second method. Everyone is saying second method. Yes, guys, both methods are good. Both the methods are good. But by the second method, you can save some seconds in your exam. Okay? Now, is it clear to all of you? If yes, write in the comment box. Yes, sir. And guys, one more thing, please attend the 8:30 session also. Attend the 8:30 PM session also on YouTube. Okay. Now, next question is this. Topic is number of divisor. I am going to teach you all number of divisor in today's 8:30 session on YouTube. All right. Budhim, the 8:30 session is in Hindi or bilingual. Okay. Now, please try to solve this question, guys. In this question, you have been given that A, B, C can complete a piece of work in 15, 20, and 30 days, respectively. A, B, C all together start the work, but after 4 days, A left the work, and B also left the work after next 2 days. Rest of the work completed by C, then in how many days total work will be completed? Okay, Budhim, don't worry. Now, guys, please try to solve this question. So, guys, this question is in your homework. Please try to solve this question. And I will start next class from this question. I will start your next class from this question. Okay. Please listen. This question is in your homework, guys. Please try to solve this question. And I will start next class from this question only. Okay. Yes, Rahul Balihara, HCFLSIM class is uploaded today. Yes. And here you have the link of the class of 8:30 p.m. Okay. So, guys, please try to solve this question and give the answer. I will start the next session from this question only. So, this is all about today's session. I hope you enjoyed the session. I hope you learned some new concepts about time and work. So, we will meet again on 4th October. Sorry, 3rd October. Today is 1st October. Okay, so we will meet again on 3rd October, right? So, first of all, yes, 13 days is the right answer. Yes. So, guys, this is all about today's session. I hope you like the session. Thank you. We'll meet again in